Here we go. Okay, so we're getting gameplay right off the bat. Oh, no. Okay, they're going straight into the performance. Nope, straight into Final Fantasy VII. Alright. New game, continue, remake. The nostalgia tingles through the room. If they could get rid... Oh, no, there we go. Just gonna continue. Hello? If that train doesn't get suplexed... Sup, Cloud? So this is supposedly gameplay footage? Is this like cutscene footage? I don't know. Okay,
please welcome Yoshinori Kitase, producer, Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Sup, Yoshinori? Someone turn his mic on. There we go.
I'm very happy to be able to introduce this long beloved title once again. After 22 years, the familiar characters we love have returned while becoming more beautiful and captivating than ever before.
There's a bit of juddering on the stream. It's actually from them.
To our longtime fans, we thank you for your support and patience over these years, and we look forward to embarking on this journey together.
FF7 をリメイクするにあたって、Final Fantasy 7の世界観やキャラクターたちをより深く今回は描いております。Final Fantasy 7リメイクプロジェクトの最初の作品となる本作では、ミッドガルのストーリーを広大にかつ緻密に語っております。またゲームデザインも今作用に最適化しておりまして、ブルーレイ2枚組相当のボリュームを見込んでおります。一本の独立したゲームとして十分期待に応える作品になっております。
Remaking Final Fantasy VII has allowed us to dive much deeper into the world and its characters than ever before. The game design was optimized for this title as well, and we anticipate 2 Blu-ray discs worth of gameplay content.
Damn!
The first game in this project expands on the story of Midgar and is such an elaborate retelling that it has become a solid standalone game in its own right.
Okay, is that the reason for it being episodic? Or is it actually episodic?
Through the content we are about to unveil today, and through all that we have yet to unveil, we will not disappoint your expectations. Your reunion with the Final Fantasy VII you know is near.
それと同時にですね、当時を知らないゲームファンの方は、全く新しいね、Final Fantasy と出会うことになります。
To newcomers who never played the original, we present to you a completely new Final Fantasy and a perfect starting point to explore the world of Final Fantasy VII.
Okay.
Please welcome Neil Pabone, Senior Manager, Product Marketing, Square Enix.
Hi, Neil.
Hi,
So, Neil is here to introduce you and walk you through gameplay.
Thank you, Katase-san.
Gameplay?
Let's mosey.
What's with the fade-out?
It's a hybrid gameplay system that merges real-time action with strategic command-based combat. For starters, each press of the square button is a swing of Cloud's Buster Sword. Cloud attacks, dodges, and blocks all in real time. His standard attacks do some damage, but they barely scratch the surface of Cloud's true potential. Succeeding on the battlefield requires much more than just hacking and slashing. Cloud needs to be tactical. He needs ATB. Two ATB bars are displayed in the lower right. These fill up slowly over time, but fill much faster as Cloud lands standard attacks. Once an ATB bar is full, you can enter tactical mode, where time slows to a crawl and you have the opportunity to choose actions from the command menu. Katase-san, I've had the pleasure of seeing quite a bit of the game, but tactical mode never gets old for me. I could just sit here all day long and watch this beautiful slow motion action.
Well, that's interesting, so it's no longer turn-based.
I think the audience would like to see more, isn't that right, everyone?
Fair enough, good point.
Yeah.
Well, once in tactical mode, you can choose to perform various abilities, such as Cloud's Braver attack. Using an item in battle will deplete an ATB charge, and if Cloud has the right materia equipped and enough MP,
ooh,
he can use ATB charges to cast spells. Of course, this being a remake, we're sure to see some familiar faces. With the use of his iconic gun arm, Barret is able to target enemies at a distance. Barret's standard attacks generate ATB charges similar to Cloud, but his abilities are entirely different. Switching between characters in combat is done with a single button press, which makes rotating through party members a snap. Speaking of other party members, Katase-san, when are we going to see Tifa in action?
Because everyone wants to see Tifa!
Soon. Alright.
Soon.
Characters will continue to fight even when you're not controlling them directly, but it's up to you to choose how and when ATB charges are used. You can maximize your effectiveness by switching between characters or issuing commands to characters with full ATB bars.
Interesting. This is a very different type of combat setup.
When the gauge is full, the enemy becomes staggered and you'll deal bonus damage. Tactical mode evokes the command selections from the original Final Fantasy VII and allows players to enjoy battle while taking the time to think strategically. For players who prefer fast-paced action, abilities and spells can be bound to shortcuts for immediate execution. Shortcuts make combat extremely dynamic, but the choice of using them is entirely up to you. Right, Katase-san?
That's right.
I prefer sticking with one character, but this back-and-forth swap seems doable at least.
Well, that's a brief introduction to combat in Final Fantasy VII Remake, and we look forward to showing you a whole lot more in the coming months. For now, let's see how Cloud and Barret do against a more formidable foe.
Thanks for that bit of exposition to explain how to kill him. But at the same time, it's still just a giant scorpion bot. Go for the joints. This back and forth in combat banter, I'm actually really enjoying. Uh-oh. The core that's literally just the ass of the scorpion. Okay, sure. Drop the barrier by attacking its weak spot. Where's the weak spot? Its ass. Uh-oh. They're really showing us the whole boss battle here. I'm okay with this. God, this is a long ass. This is a long ass boss battle. God damn. Oh, damn. About frickin' time, too. I know JRPGs like to kind of have long boss battles. This is kind of ridiculous. Sure. Giving everyone the Sephiroth. They're just pulling the entire team out at this point.
Thank you for joining us, Nomura-san. It is an absolute honor to have you here. Katase-san, how do you feel working with Nomura-san once again on Final Fantasy VII Remake?
Hi, Karuta ですね、原作のFF7以降、何作もね、一緒にね、その後も仕事はしてるんですけども、今作にはね、2人ね、ディレクションキャラクターデザイナーとしてね、ストーリーとね、
Since the original Final Fantasy VII, I've worked with him on many titles, but it has been a while since we've actually had him work so heavily on a project like this, from the direction to character design to the story. And I'm really happy to see him working on this title with the same passion that he had 22 years ago. Nomura-san, comment, please.
今まで結構長い間お待たせしましたが、ずっと応援してくださっているファンの皆様、本当にありがとうございました。 そしてですね、皆さん今日初めて、プレイ画面を結構長めに見たと思いますが、
What is she writing down? Should she not know their lines?
だったんじゃないかなと、思っております。
So first and foremost, we wanted to extend our gratitude to those who have been waiting so patiently and have been supporting us for such a long time until now. And also, we've taken a look at gameplay right now, and we've fairly showed you a good bit.
でですね、まあそういうわけなので、皆さんぜひ触れてみたいんじゃないかなと思いましてですね、実際に、触ってみたいですかね。
And I was wondering, do you guys want to actually play the game?
Is that really a question?
ということでですね、明日から開催されます E3 のですね、SqueEnix ブースの方で、セブンリメイク、プレイアブル出展していますので、ぜひ機会のある方は、触れてみてください。
So we actually have playable demo kiosks available at the SqueEnix E3 booth. So I hope you have the opportunity to try it out.
Lucky bastards.
はい。
What?
それではですね、最後に。
The hell did that dude shout?
昨日はですね、コンサートの方でショート版のトレーラーを、公開しましたけども、今日はロング版をご用意してますので、ぜひご覧ください。
So finally, there is something that we wanted to show you. Yesterday we showed you a short version of a trailer at the Final Fantasy VII concert. Today we have a longer version.
A longer version of the same trailer you saw yesterday.It'd be awesome if they got rid of the closed captioning.
Nothing worth fighting for was ever won without sacrifice.
Help me!
Magic! Yo, Tifa!Some of that, cool action with Tifa. The team setup only seems to be... Well, there's Sephiroth. I have a favor to ask of you. Run away. You have to live. You have to live. You bastard!
Yeah! Hold on to that hatred.
The team setup only seems to be maxed out at 3. It doesn't seem like they're going to let you go to full 4. 3-3-2020, you have a real estate, folks. Pre-order now! And the first class edition, you get a statue. Okay, now we're into the other games of Square Enix. Can we turn the closed captioning off? There we go. Jesus Christ, I didn't know I had control of the closed captioning. All the emotional journeys. Look at all the streamers and other YouTubers who've supported our games and love us. As long as we're together. I want to see what his power can do. Come on, Daniel. You got this. He's starting to be able to control his powers. Psychic powers! It's not a superhero story unless the father figure dies. Or a parental figure, I should say. But why the fuck would you show that in the trailer? Like, that is a significant plot detail. Why the fuck would you show that in a trailer? And of course, fucking puppies. But can you pet the dog? That's the question. Can you pet the dog? Everyone's trying to guess when the ending is happening. Life is Strange 2! Play it today! Okay. What is this? Miasma in check, but the crystal's power is not eternal. These are the chronicles of brave young adventurers who wait a second. These are the crystal chronicles. Oh, for fuck's sake. If we had no crystals, miasma would consume us all, correct? Never did I imagine that it could be so bright. An online multiplayer mode, caravan with friends. Interesting. Keep the adventure close at hand. The journey now unfolds on smartphones. Crystal Chronicles on mobile. Crystal Chronicles Remastered Edition. This winter, embark on a new journey once more. Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicle Remastered. Oh god. Octopath Traveler now on PC. I recommend you get it. I got it when it was released on the Switch, and I have yet to finish it. Yeah. But if you love the classic JRPG style, Octopath will scratch that itch for you. Aside from Final Fantasy VII, nothing special. What do we have here? I have no idea what this is. The Last Remnant Remastered. This is slowly turning to available tonight on the Switch. This is slowly turning into Square Enix Remastered Conference, because that's all they're showing us. Okay. All right.
The children of Hargon, the vile cult that worships destruction, has outlawed the building, cooking, and creation of all things, and captured the builders.
Sure, because you can run a kingdom without those. All it's telling me is that this is Minecraft with adventure and RPG.
Dive into the watery depths to discover hidden treasures. Climb the highest mountains to catch the sunset. And glide home to rest up for your next day of adventure. But beware. Monsters roam this land and will need to be dispatched with cunning composure. Luckily, accompanying you on your quest is the enigmatic Malron, an aggressive amnesiac with a fondness for fighting foes. Use powerful attacks on the battlefield to take down monstrous beasts! Work together with your villagers to till soil, plant seeds, and raise a multitude of crops. Be sure to customize the way you build your fields to support the kind of crops you're growing. Harvest anything from the humble cabbage and wheat to tantalizingly tasty tomatoes.
Oh god, all the iteration of teas.
Big projects require big, big help.
Co-op.
Three friends can team up online to build anything you can imagine. Let your creativity run wild. Your imagination, so call on your friends and build your fate together.
It's always the freaking slime.
The road you build is paved with peril, young builder. Only you can defeat the children of Hargon. Bring an end to destruction and save the world in Dragon Quest Builders 2!
I feel that the narrator is like, he's trying to be serious, but at the same time playful, and it's just falling flat on both counts. Playable demo available June 27th. What's coming to Switch? Oh, dang. Let's do this. I believe in you. I believe in the Luminary.
Do not lose heart. Do not look back. Remember, you're the Luminary. We believe in you.
And Dragon Quest, was that 11? Echoes of an Elusive Age, Definitive Edition S. Alright, sure. Let's show off all of our indie titles, because we love people, and we love our indies. None of which I've actually heard of. More indies! This is a car.
Something different. We want to do this by reviving a style that pioneered racing games decades ago.
Our game mixes
arcade titles
with a classic sharp arcade look and tactile driving physics, which brings together a whole range of styles and eras of motorsport.
We are delighted to share this moment with you and show a sneak preview of our game, which SqueEnix Collective will publish in 2020.
Join us for the ride and see you again soon.
So we're looking at, yep, top-down, arcadey, micro-driving. I got nothing. Circuit Superstars! Does it?
You'll need to quickly coordinate strategies with your team on the fly, whilst keeping your movement nimble and your aim precise if you hope to beat out the competition.
there are multiple game modes for you and your team to dive into.
And a couple map rip-offs. So what they're telling me is that they ripped off the Call of Duty formula and have doubled down on the esports potential. That's really what they're telling me here. Okay. Okay. This is entirely new, at least to me. Full orchestra in the diner. I was hoping for the fucking orchestra in the fucking diner. How dare you rip that away from me? Disney Pixar, more fucking Kingdom Hearts. This isn't spoken dialogue yet. What is this? Another Kingdom Hearts spinoff? Okay, it's the next DLC for Kingdom Hearts 3. I've never really cared for Kingdom Hearts, so, okay.
Naoki Yoshida, producer and director, Final Fantasy 14 Online.
More Final Fantasy 14, because that game is still going. And that was all the English we were going to get out of him.
So
we'd like to take a little bit of your time to show off Shadowbringers Final Fantasy XIV's third expansion pack, which is releasing on July the 2nd.
2013年に新生オルゼア、ア・レルムリボーンが発売されてから6年が経ちました。なんと世界で累計登録アカウント数1600万を突破し、なんとこのですね、漆黒のヴィランズの発売を前にして有料会員数も過去最高を更新することができました。これらは全て世界中のプレイヤー、光の戦士の皆さんのおかげです。この場を借りて改めてお礼申し上げます。
It's been 6 years since the release of A Realm Reborn in 2013, and over the years we have surpassed 16 million total registered users. Plus, we have reached the highest number of active subscribers in history, in its history, before the launch of Shadowbringers. This is all thanks to our players, our Warriors of Light.
このシャドーブリンガーズではですね、拡張パッケージにとどまらない新作 RPG 一本分のボリュームと、そしてゲーム体験をお届けしたいと思います。
We view Shadowbringers as more than a simple expansion pack, but as a new game filled with volume and gameplay experiences that are comparable to a brand new standalone RPG title.
また新ジョブであるガンブレイカー、それから踊り子、新種族のロスガルとビエラなど、これからファイナルファンタジー14を始める皆さんにも多数の新規の要素が用意されています。
And there are so many new elements in the game for those who have yet to play Final Fantasy 14, including two new jobs, the Gunbreaker and the Dancer, as well as two new playable races, the Frothgar and the Vira.
ぜひファイナルファンタジーシリーズの最新作としてファイナルファンタジー7リメイクの発売、2020年3月3日までの間、漆黒のヴィランズをお楽しみください。
He mentioned Final Fantasy 7 and someone wet themselves.
The latest installment in the Final Fantasy franchise for our fans to enjoy. At least until 2020 March 3rd, when Final Fantasy 7 Remake comes out.
それではいよいよ7月2日。
He knows what the people really want.
世界初公開となるその漆黒のヴィランズのローンチトレーラーをご覧いただこうと思います。
We are pleased to bring a world premiere of the launch trailer for Shadowbringers, releasing on July the 2nd.
Please take a look.
Well, it ain't the oldest joke in the book. And when, pray tell, did we last have a dark night? Over 100 bleeds.
In that chaotic no man's land between realms, time and space warp and blend in unexpected ways. What Orange saw was the future.
It's a lot of audio just overlapping in this shit.
That's how the Sin Eaters came to be. They were once living creatures, people that were caught in part of the Flood. Once the change is wrought, there is no going back.
Is there ever any going back when you've been cursed and changed? Primordial light. If
that's all three,
that's a fat ass, is what that is.
Sin Eaters are part of Yulmore society, but they must be fed with ether. Living ether.
They must be fed with people.
This world's beyond saving. Like those who try to save it.
You know, it's a game that should interest me. Unfortunately, it's part of a franchise that never has. Honestly, there's really only like one type of title from Square Enix that would absolutely interest me, and that's Lost Odyssey. Get a remake or a continuation of that would just be lovely. But unfortunately, I think that game is owned by Microsoft and not by Square Enix. And plus, this is just another MMO. I already have, you know, my one MMO that I regularly play, and I have World of Warcraft Vanilla. World of Warcraft Classic on my radar. And the one that I regularly play is Guild Wars 2, and I'm waiting on the next expansion announcement for that. Because they just finished up the Living World Season 4, which left it fucking open-ended.
The will of the star was made manifest.
I'm sorry, I can only assume I misheard, but it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Hydaelyn are not gods.
But they are gods after a fashion, yes. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
Primals! More dangerous than gods! All depends on how you tier them, but yeah, okay. Not a whole lot of excitement. Techland. What do we got from Techland? Zombies! Oh, the parkour! Dying Light 2! Wasn't exactly a huge fan of the first Dying Light, so I have no reason to pick up the second. Okay, cool. Another freaking pop-up. I should have set myself to busy on Steam. Oh well. Okay, what do we have here? Romancing what? Your choices matter. Okay, that scenario, it seemed like the choice didn't really matter. Yes, thank you, Steam. I don't care that my friend is currently playing. I will certainly give this to Square Enix. They are better at showing us gameplay and shit that actually matters. So, Romancing Saga and Saga Scarlet Grace? Yeah. Coming soon! I keep bouncing around to a lot of paintings. How many more paintings do we fucking have? And more info about their mobile game that I can't give a damn about.
The international reveal of a new title born from the FFBE universe.
Sure.
War of the Visions, Final Fantasy, Brave Exvius. These two titles, FFBE and War of the Visions, will be the pillars of the growing world of Lapis. This is the story of Ardora, a Kanyan of Lapis. A tiny spark here ignites the flames that would embroil the entire continent in conflict. A conflict later spoken of as the War of the Visions.
Okay. That never turns out well, if history has shown us. You have two heirs to the throne, you're gonna get fucked. Wise king.
Fenis, where the king of the savages has organized the barbarian tribes into Ardora's mightiest militant state.
And has the follower with the best tits.
Sanctum, a religious city-state with believers throughout Ardora, founded by one who claims to be God. Each burden with its
of course, there's always a character with a God complex.
On a struggle in which the fate of nations rests. All is for one's homeland. War of the Visions, Final Fantasy. Now in development.
Now in development. Not even close to being done, and you still give us a trailer for something that's in development. Okay. What the hell are we getting from People Can Fly? Now you actually have my interest. I got some Death, Love, and Robot flashbacks from that cryosleep bit. What literal hellscape is this? I did say literal hellscape. I'm expecting the Doom Marine at some point. Outriders. Okay. Okay, didn't tell us shit, but looks like something that has to do with hell. Fighting off the apocalypse.
Please welcome Sebastian Wojciechowski, studio head, People Can Fly.
Storm and Geese of War Judgment.
It has? All right.
I enjoy Gears of War Judgment.
It feels great to be here and feels amazing to be able to finally announce Outriders. I'd like to thank the team at People Can Fly. You guys are amazing, and I know that some of you are watching this live, even though it's 4 a.m. in the morning in Poland, so make a noise for them, please.
People in Poland, wake the fuck up.
Thank you. Thank you. And of course, Square Enix for the help and support as we work together on this exciting new IP. You know, over the past few years, People Can Fly has grown to over 200 developers and 4 studios across Poland, the UK, and most recently the US to bring you what is our most ambitious shooter to date. To present more of our vision, I would like to take this moment to introduce a short video from our game director, Bartek Mita. So thanks a lot. More on Outriders this winter. Thank you.
Okay. At least a little bit of info. Something about what it is.
Shooters are in our DNA. It's our passion. And it's what we do. Outriders draws on all our experience from all our previous titles. It's a game we wanted to make for a very long time. We describe Outriders as a dark, modern shooter built with traditional values. By that, I mean we are creating an experience with a strong story that you can enjoy with your friends or on your own. We want to tell a complete story. We are confident. We are building a shooter with a powerful gunplay, incredible weaponry, and a hostile new world we want to spend many hours in. It's a game we've had in our heads ever since People Can Fly left Epic Games. Outriders is a 1-2 or 3-player drop-in, drop-out co-op shooter. In our game, you will create your own Outrider and journey across the hostile planet of Enoch in search of the source of a mysterious signal.
Souls of the what?
It's a dark and unforgiving world. And yes, there is a lot more depth to the game, but I can't say too much more right now.
So, custom character, drop-in, drop-out, shooter. And you go around hunting souls. Yeah, this sounds like the fucking apocalypse. It's starting to get full up. Is this the last one?
Incarnation is the foundation of our way of life. We celebrate the lives we've been given and offer up prayers for the next. It is grief of death which shackles the living and causes the dead to stray. Indeed, there is no greater affront to reincarnation. So we turn our grief to joy as we send off the dead.
What not, apparently not morbid tale is this?
Those who held back their tears in life still need salvation in death. A duty that falls to the Watchers. The Watchers sever the bonds that tie the lost to this world and send them off to the next. They navigate the emotions of the living and the dead. They prize life above all else.
And so they attack the dead and sorrowful?
This is the story of one Watcher.
Oninaki. Okay, August 22nd. It's new, but again, it's another thing that just... No. Bye. Hi. Bye. Thanks for coming. Final Fantasy VIII? More Final Fantasy! It really shouldn't surprise me that this is just so Final Fantasy heavy. Coming sooner than Final Fantasy VII! Somehow. The following trailer was created with in-game footage. Ace Combat? Avengers! And Crystal Dynamics. Oh god. So we have this Square Enix team mixing with the Tomb Raider team to make... What? Didn't even show us a transition. It's just a hard cut to Hulk.
Is that a joke? Did Thor make a joke?
Yes, he did. I'm just trying to figure out what this is.
Not how the story ends.
a lot of Avengers something.
What are we waiting for?
That.
Please welcome Sean Eskai, Creative Director, Crystal Dynamics, and Bill Roseman, Vice President and Creative Director, Marvel Games.
Oh boy. All right.
Yeah. Thank you. We love you. Yeah.
All the Avengers hype. The movies are over, so now we're making games.
We are incredibly excited to reveal Marvel's Avengers to the world. A few years ago, Crystal Dynamics and Marvel began collaborating on an original Avengers game. One that combined epic action adventure with cinematic storytelling. A game where we as players can experience in both single player and co-op what it's like to be Earth's mightiest heroes.
Do I have any true believers in the house? Yeah. Awesome. Because you will instantly recognize your favorite superheroes and villains, but you'll also see that they're unique to this game, as this is Crystal's interpretation of these iconic characters.
You better not fuck it up, Crystal.
San Francisco celebrates the opening of the Avengers West Coast headquarters, and the team's custom helicarrier, outfitted with a strange experimental energy source.
Space crystals!
An attempt to steal this new technology results in massive destruction.
Based on the trailer, it was a successful attempt.
The Avengers are outlawed, and our heroes disbanded.
5 years later, a horrific evil threatens the world, and our only hope is to reassemble Earth's mightiest heroes.
Mightiest?
You'll play as your favorite Avengers in an all-new original story, showcasing authentic Marvel heroism and humanity. It's about losing what matters to you most and fighting to get it back.
Yeah! Yeah!
I want to be excited for this, but
our individual powers and learning that together we are mighty.
You'll lead the team as the legendary super soldier Captain America. You'll call down the lightning as the Asgardian god of thunder, Thor. You'll channel
with his weird beard
Bruce Banner by unleashing the Hulk. You'll gather intel and strike swiftly as the ultimate tactical spy, Black Widow. And finally,
he enjoys his arm motions a lot.
Charismatic Tony Stark.
Charismatic? That's not the word I'd use.
As the armored Iron Man.
To bring this incredible story to life, we've assembled an all-star cast. I'll let them introduce themselves.
Show off the team. Hi, Troy Baker.
Here we are. Avengers assembled.
And Nolan North.
Hi, I'm Troy Baker, and I play Bruce Banner.
Hi, I'm Jeff Shine, and I play Captain America.
Hi, I'm Travis Willingham, and I play Thor.
Hi, I'm Laura Bailey, and I'm playing Black Widow.
Hi, I'm Nolan North, and I play Tony Stark. And there's certain characters I don't think you ever have to be talked into.
Yeah.
You know, so we'd like to have you play Tony Stark Iron Man. Yeah, yes. You know, everybody always portrays him as this super confident character. I think it's a mask for him. I think he's one of the most vulnerable guys.
I think Bruce is just such a cool character. A lot of people are really quick to bring out the big green, but I think that Bruce is a super complex character. He's fun, and I've never played him before.
What is very relatable about Natasha is she's extremely capable, but she's at the core, she's human. She's surrounded by all of this larger-than-life stuff, and she has to step up to it.
And she's just there with her gadgets and spiteness.
For me, I like where he's kind of landed in the public eye, you know?
One of the things I think is cool about Cap is I never feel like he necessarily wants to be a leader. He accepts that he is. I feel like sometimes the best leaders are the ones who don't necessarily want to be, but they're right for the job.
Having an original story to tell as well, what they've done at Crystal Dynamics is great, so I think everybody's going to be pretty stoked.
The Avengers are at their best when they are all together, but the chemistry is... do not shake.
Thanks, everybody, for joining us. Can't wait for you to be able to play the game, but right now, you don't have to wait for some exclusive content.
Five years after A-Day. Was that Avengers Day?
Pose a danger to society. That was the question, Bruce. That was the question.
Did you even check the science?
It was a heist, Bruce.
No.
We were outsmarted.
The Terrigen reactor was unstable, and you knew that. You knew that, and you still paraded it before the entire world.
So what? We just give up. We didn't give up, Tony. We failed. At least I can admit that. We failed him. We failed him.
Please welcome Scott Amos, Head of Studio, and Megan Marie, Senior Community and Social Media Manager, Crystal Dynamics.
I'm running out of words to say about all this because I'm going to end up sounding like a broken record. He's wearing the Avengers shirt, but is wearing a button-up over it.
A high-level view of the cinematic and character-driven campaign of Marvel's Avengers. But launch is only the beginning of this adventure.
Marvel's Avengers delivers a narrative over multiple years, with exciting new content released at a regular basis.
Like the Avengers,
what kind of jacket top is that?
Together. You'll assemble into teams of up to four players online.
Yeah, that's kind of what I figured from the initial trailer.
Extraordinary abilities, where you can customize a growing roster of heroes and defend the Earth from ever-escalating threats.
Because that's how superheroes work.
And to make sure everyone comes on this journey with us, we're incredibly thrilled to announce that every new superhero and every new region will be delivered at no additional cost.
Okay. We'll see how long that sticks around.
So our promise to the community is that we won't have random loot boxes or pay-to-win scenarios.
Still microtransactions for cosmetics. I'm sure. Pause each time for applause.
Our new Crystal Northwest studio and everyone at Square Enix.
So our game is about embracing your powers and living your superhero dreams. We have an exclusive gameplay demo in our booth that will show you more of the core campaign, its original story, and our superheroes in action.
And you're not going to give it to the rest of us in trailer form.
So, Marvel's Avengers will release worldwide on PS4, Xbox One, Stadia, and PC.
No one cares about Stadia, but okay.
We got you covered. And we're excited to be partnering with PlayStation to bring some awesome surprises to the PlayStation audience.
PlayStation exclusives!
Including early beta access. Benefits that we'll be revealing in the future.
Okay.
But before we go, glimpse into our world, including when you'll get to play this game. This is what's next for the Avengers. Thank you, true believers.
And a release date, so this better be good. What's up, Ant-Man?
Unbelievable. It worked.
It's sort of cute when they're small.
Ah, I didn't doubt you for a second, Hank.
Bullshit. May 15. And I guess that is indeed everything. Okay, so some original announcements. Yeah, okay, and now all their rights and stuff. All the titles, all the stuff. So, honestly, not a whole lot I found interesting. Honestly, a little bit more interesting, certainly more unique stuff than what Bethesda gave us yesterday. Kind of a brief overview. Final Fantasy VII. Actually gave us a full gameplay trailer with a boss fight, and a release date, March 3rd, 2020. Announcement of Dragon Quest Builders 2. These are my highlights that I've written down. I don't really care about the rest. And I guess they're going offline now? Because they just went straight to black. Okay, sure. Let's do this then. Hi, everybody. So, yeah, we're just going to do it this way, and it's going to be terrible, but fuck it. So, weird clicks. All right. So, kind of the highlights of the day, at least for me. Again, Final Fantasy VII, that whole deal. Good job starting off strong with that. Next thing that was good, Dragon Quest Builders 2. Didn't really care much for the first one, not enough to grab it. Builders 2, again, like I said, was basically their take on the Minecraft formula. Some people will love it, I personally won't really care. Dragon Quest II on the Switch, if you are, into that. Was it Dragon Quest II? I think it was. That, or it's, no. Dragon Quest XI? No. I don't know. But yeah, another Dragon Quest is coming out on, oh, sure, now they actually put it back up. Oh, well. Yeah, Dragon Quest being ported to the Switch. Outriders by People Can Fly, for those who enjoyed, Bulletstorm and or Gears of War Judgment, that is, definitely something to look into. I will be, certainly keeping an eye on that one. I enjoyed Judgment, so this one is an interesting potential, plus I just enjoy anything that tackles a kind of a demonic or religious apocalypse, basically hell taking over. I'll be fascinated by that. Final Fantasy VIII Remastered coming out later this fall/winter. I'm going to expect a Christmas release date on that one. And obviously, Marvel's Avenger Coming out PC, PS4, Xbox, Stadia, May 15, 2020. And that one's going to be... They're looking at a long-term, story-driven, four-player co-op something or another. Sure. I'll wait to see more of that. So, once again, thank you all very much for joining me on these conferences. We got one more to go to tomorrow, and that is Nintendo's Direct, and then that will be me done with the coverage of E3. So if you all would please... immediately lost my train of thought. Thank you all very much for coming. Please be sure to follow me here on Twitch and head over to my Twitter @tornado_wolf and follow me there. I'm just going to go ahead and take these off now because we don't need them anymore. And if you would head over to my YouTube channel, you should be able to find it. The link is still stupidly long because I haven't gotten the rights to make a custom one yet, but I will... be linking all of these VODs that I have covered over the conferences to my YouTube channel. So be sure to head over there while watching me on my Twitter for those links and then head over to my YouTube channel there. I know I'm making this terribly long, but... and subscribe and give me a follow there. I will be posting a lot more video stuff in the... near future, especially when it comes to VODs, Twitch highlights, and reviews, along with whatever stuff I find worthwhile to post there. I'll be using it for all sorts of things, not just my gaming journalism, but also my own projects in all of their forms. And finally, if you want kind of the caviar, the collection of all of this, head over to my website, thelegacygamer.wordpress.com. That is where I post all of this stuff along with a few other goodies, especially articles over all of this stuff, much like the conferences today. That is where I will be posting my highlight later today, if not tomorrow. Once again, thank you all very much for watching, and until next time, good hunting.